Good morning students, welcome back. Today in this video we are going to learn about the email writing. What is an email, why do we write an email, and what all things are needed to compose an email. Now first let's understand what is an email. Now email stands for electronic mail. Electronic, when I say, it means that we have to type it on a computer, on a mobile phone, and we need to have an internet connection. If we don't have internet connection, we can't compose email. Now the other question is, why do we write email? We write email to save our time. Okay, in the olden days people used to write in a manual way. People used to write it on a paper. People used to write their letter on a paper, on a piece of paper, go to the post office, post it, and then the letter would travel for 3, 4, or 10 days, maybe longer than that, and then it would be received by the receiver. But now at present people write email, people compose email, and within one click you can easily send your message to the other person to whom you want to convey your message. Now what are the requirements, what all things are needed to compose an email? First, you need to have a phone, laptop, computer, desktop, all these things are required. Then you need to have an internet connection. Then when you have internet connection, you need to make your own email ID. And you also need to know the person's email ID to whom you are sending the message or the mail. Okay, so all of these are the requirements for composing an email. Now we follow a format for email. The format is mentioned over here. At first you can see what I've written is to. Now in this box, even if you open in your mobile phones, you will see that when you press compose, the page that opens, the first thing that you will see is to. Now in this section, in this blank, what do we need to write? Over here we need to mention the receiver's email ID. Receiver's email ID means receiver's email address, estrong41@gmail.com. rohan362@yahoo.com. These are called email ID. Now in to you have to write the receivers, the one who is going to read the email. From, the second thing is from. Now in from you need to write down your email address. You don't need to write, it will automatically be filled by your phone or your computer. Okay, because whenever you use your phone, at the time of starting your phone, once you go to the shop and buy the phone, The moment you switch on the phone, it will ask for an internet connection, and once you open the phone, switch on the phone, it will ask you to make an ID, and that ID is automatically saved by your phone, computer or laptops, and then you can easily see that the moment it is already filled in your in the format. Okay, the sender's address is already there, you don't need to fill because it's already there. And if it's not there, you can simply write your email ID also. But generally we can see that in this section, in this blank, in this box, the email ID, your email ID will be already written, will be already there. Okay, then comes the subject. Now subject, as we wrote in the formal and informal letter, we have seen that for formal letters we write the subject, and for informal we don't use the subject, we don't write the subject. So that is the same thing that we have to follow over here. If you are writing a formal email, you need to give the subject, and if you are writing informal email, then you don't need to write. Okay. Now the next one is the body. The body, there will be a big box inside which you have to write the message, you have to compose your email. Okay. And there you will have to follow the same thing that we followed for letter. That is the salutation, respected sir, dear sir. That is the salutation, the message that you want to write, what you want to convey, and at last, subscription, yours lovingly, yours loving daughter, your loving son, your name, and close it. Now, one thing you have to make note over here is that in different phones, we have got different system. Okay? So, it might happen at some places that the from these two, to and from, they can be vice versa, meaning sometimes from can be on top, sometimes to will be on top. But you don't need to get confused. Even if you write from on the top, that will be correct. Okay, because email is not a proper format. The email format which we follow, it can't be practiced on the board. Okay, email format is there in the phone and computers and the laptops and desktop. Okay, so whatever the Google or Gmail provides you with, that we have to follow. Okay, so these are the format which we can go with and we can practice, and you also can practice. Try to get your friend's email, try composing email and sending it to them. So once you are familiar with what the page looks like, you will be familiar with the format also. Okay, and if you have any problem or any confusion with any of these things, you can ask me on my WhatsApp.